what do we know about in India so far? Because, you know, there were a lot of concerns when we had those. We have some of the cases that have been identified from the UK, but many suspect there are probably many more cases of, you know, the variant which is identified in the United Kingdom. And but so far, and people even questioning whether the numbers that are going up now, especially like in Maharashtra that we're seeing, that it could be blamed on these variants?
It could be, but I think it's also our behavior. Ultimately, whether it's the prototype SARS-CoV-2 or OG SARS-CoV-2, as some call it, or the variants of concern, the same public health interventions work. We might have to be more compliant with them, but they work. So in Maharashtra, we've also started in some cities to open up trains. There's increased social contact. And I think we're going to start to see this across the country. Maybe Maharashtra is doing a better job picking up the spread right now, but I think this is going to be a problem we have to contend with across the country.
And what steps, you know, we're already seeing that the chief minister has called for meetings, a lot of discussions going on. Now, from the 1st of March, there'll be the next phase of the vaccinations. And that is something that, you know, will hopefully be, you know, there'll be, it'll be quickened, the entire vaccination process, so we can reach out to more and more people. So Maharashtra specifically remains a big concern. It was the state with the largest number of cases initially. And now again, it's been reporting over 8,000 new cases over the last 2 days. And that's after a gap of around 3 months.
You know, Maharashtra has several large cities, densely populated cities. So we do have a lot of risk here as we begin to open up. I believe we're going to start seeing this in other places as well. What we really need to do is, like you pointed out, scale vaccinations. And specifically in those areas where we're starting to see increased transmission. So this is like providing ring immunity to that area, preventing spread. We specifically also need to protect the immunocompromised individuals, because what we are seeing is that in immunocompromised people, the virus can keep replicating for a long time and evolve very quickly. So maybe we need to identify these individuals, prioritize them for vaccination, and keep them safe. But of course, we also need to start rolling out the other vaccines that can potentially stop transmission, like the nasal vaccines, Covovax. So there's a lot we can do and a lot we need to do.
All right, Dr. Swapnil Parekh, thank you so much for speaking to us here at NDTV.